Tell me about the release.
Yeah, really, really troubling incident from the standpoint of law enforcement or as a parent. We essentially were contacted by law enforcement in Texas, in the United States. Down there, they located a 11-year-old male victim. At the time, they felt that he was the victim of extortion and cyberbullying. Certainly, a lot of the evidence that they presented to us was that somebody they believed in Abbotsford was compelling this young child to produce images, naked images and sexual images, both images and video, and that there was a relationship that was formed online between this 11-year-old boy and someone unknown age in Abbotsford. It afforded us the ability to then start looking for that suspect. And the troubling aspect here is when we located that suspect, we learned that he, in fact, was in his mid-teens, and certainly all of the allegations that were asserted in Texas turned out to be true after we executed a search warrant at a residence in Abbotsford in February. In early March, we arrested the mid-teen male. He will be going before the courts ultimately, and certainly through the cooperation of law enforcement on both sides of the border, as well as Crown Counsel, we certainly hope that we can bring this incident to fruition through the court system.
What kind of charges is this kid facing?
Yeah, a multitude of charges, from extortion to child luring to sexual exploitation to some charges that are specific to child pornography. Essentially what was happening here was that either through threat of repercussions, and there were a variety of repercussions that were mentioned, or through inducement through rewards, this mid-teened male from Abbotsford was compelling this 11-year-old child from Texas to do things, and then to send those things electronically to him via the internet.
And how unusual is this for like the ages that we're talking about?
Yeah, I mean, regrettably, you know, it's not uncommon for police in any jurisdiction to tell of child pornography charges or even sexual exploitation charges, adults against children. Here we have a youth against a child, and so that definitely is more rare. There are many, many troubling aspects of this investigation, the details of which I obviously can't get into. But suffice it to say, as someone who's been in law enforcement for 19 years and who's been a father for 16 years, this sends shivers down your spine. It is one of those things where I am telling everyone I know that they need to do everything they can to safeguard their kids. The world of the internet, social media, being online has made the world smaller in many respects, which has afforded people the ability to communicate in live time and to share information. But it also has afforded criminals the ability to make those same connections. And we as parents, we as community members have to do everything we can to safeguard our kids.
Given the ages of the victim and of the actual suspect, what could he be facing as far as courts and as far as if he's found guilty?
Yeah, there's a multitude of things that that will be in play here. Certainly, I won't comment specifically on this case, but there has been precedent in other cases to, depending on the circumstances, have the youth elevated to adult court. I don't know if that will be the case here, but certainly there are very serious charges that have now been approved by Crown.
And are there any other victims, do you believe?
Yeah, at this point in time, we don't believe there are additional victims. We think that through the courage of this 11-year-old boy, reaching out to his parent, I mean, you have to imagine that there were threats going back and forth, that this was a long-running dialogue, and yet this boy still had the courage, despite those threats, to do the right thing and talk to his parents about what was going on. If not for that, he could have been further victimized, he could have been more seriously victimized, and it was serious enough, or there could have been more victims. So absolutely, this 11-year-old boy in Texas showed absolute courage in coming forward.
Given the distance and where all this was taking place, how hard was this to investigate and actually find the suspect?
Yeah, I mean, we're fortunate. We have major crime detectives who are seasoned professionals who have been doing this and have been doing some excellent work, even when you compare it to other jurisdictions, even other parts of Canada. I think we're cutting edge as far as getting that information and then laying those charges. And so it doesn't matter what side of the border. I mean, one of the advantages to working this type of investigation is a lot of those boundaries come down because you're essentially trying to hone in on somebody. And certainly we did that here.